In the roaring 20th century, a groundbreaking invention lay buried, shadowed by the might of oil and coal. This is the story of the Sun Engine, a leap into renewable energy forgotten and overshadowed by the renowned figures of Rockefeller and Edison. It was the blueprint for a cleaner world and a huge threat to the established order of energy giants. Yet its story remains untold, its potential unexplored. But what was this Sun Engine, and why did it fade into the shadows obscured by the towering influence of industrial titans? Hello and welcome back to Eccentric History. In today's video, we are unraveling the lost tale of the Sun Engine. But before we do so, don't forget to hit that like button and subscribe. Let's get started. The historical background. As the 20th century began, Philadelphia stood as a bustling hub of industry, its skyline dominated by smokestacks and its air thick with the fumes of progress. In this era, coal was king, and it's used to power factories, trains, and heat homes, fueling the rapid industrialization that marked the period. Yet, this reliance on coal came at a steep cost to the environment. The city's air was filled with pollutants, casting a dark veil over its streets and choking its residents. In 1904, long before environmental protection became a global concern, Philadelphia's city administrators took a leading step. They introduced regulations to curb the emission of smoke and fumes, a bold move in an age where industrial prowess was often measured by the billowing smoke of factories. This regulation, a precursor to the country's Air Pollution Act of 1955, sought to penalize those who contributed to the city's worsening air quality. Against this backdrop of pollution and rising regulation, an idea began to take root. It was the concept of harnessing a clean, inexhaustible energy source, the sun. This idea stood in contrast to the prevailing energy practices. While the world leaned heavily on coal, a few visionary minds were already gazing towards the sky, imagining a future powered by the sun's rays. This juxtaposition set the stage for an extraordinary chapter in the history of energy, one that would challenge the established order and envision a new path forward. Frank Schuman's vision. This is where an inventor, not content with the status quo, Frank Schuman comes into the picture. His journey into innovation began in the 1890s, a period marked by industrial might and mechanical marvels. Schuman, initially known for his method of strengthening glass with internal wires, made a name for himself with creations that combined practicality and ingenuity. This glass, more resilient to fire and less likely to shatter into dangerous shards, quickly found favor in institutions like schools and prisons. But Schuman's true passion lay in utilizing the power of nature. In 1906, he turned his attention and resources towards a groundbreaking concept, the Sun Engine. This device was a depiction of human ingenuity, leveraging the sun's rays to power machinery. At its heart was a system of reflectors strategically placed around insulated boxes on swivels, tracking the sun's journey across the sky. These reflectors concentrated sunlight onto a vessel containing water in a vacuum, lowering its boiling point. This innovation allowed the creation of low-pressure steam, which was then used to drive a steam engine. By 1910, Schuman had refined his invention to power small-scale applications, like a toy train, using vaporized ether, demonstrating the practicality of solar power. In an era where coal dominated, Schuman's Sun Engine was more than just an invention. It was a bold statement. It challenged the prevailing energy norms and opened up a conversation about sustainable and clean energy sources. His work stood as a beacon of potential change, highlighting the power of renewable resources in a world heavily dependent on fossil fuels. The conspiracy. In the early 1900s, as Frank Schuman was developing his Sun Engine, John D. Rockefeller and Thomas Edison were already well established as titans of the energy industry. Rockefeller's control over the oil industry and Edison's innovations in electricity had made them influential figures in shaping how the world accessed and used energy. The emergence of Schuman's solar technology presented a potential challenge to their dominance. A successful, scalable solar engine promised a shift towards renewable energy, potentially disrupting the lucrative coal and oil markets. In this context, there arose speculation about the extent to which Rockefeller and Edison might have felt threatened by Schuman's innovations. Historical records and anecdotes provide the strategies they employed to maintain their supremacy. Did they use their considerable influence to sway public opinion against solar energy? Could they have leveraged their vast networks to create obstacles for Schuman's technology in the market? While hard evidence of deliberate suppression is scant, the possibility that Schuman's work was strategically overshadowed by these industrialists adds a layer of intrigue to the story. This scenario paints a picture of a historical turning point where the future of energy could have taken a very different path, had Schuman's invention gained the support it deserved. Before we move on, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe to Eccentric History for more amazing content. Global attention and British interest. While skepticism and intrigue surrounded Schuman's Sun engine in the United States, news of his revolutionary technology managed to reach far beyond American borders, finding a receptive audience in Egypt. By 1913, Egypt, then under British control, became a pivotal stage for Schuman to showcase his invention. This was a land where the relentless sun and vast arid expanse presented an ideal testing ground for his solar engine. In Egypt, Schuman organized demonstrations of his technology, capturing the attention of British officials who quickly recognized its potential. These demonstrations weren't mere technical showcases, they were grand events with leaming rows of solar collectors set against the Egyptian landscape, and Schuman articulating his vision of a future powered by the sun. The British, with their expansive empire and ever-growing energy needs, saw in Schuman's technology a solution that could revolutionize how they managed their territories. The implications of Schuman's solar engine were significant for the British Empire. If successful, it could offer a sustainable and cost-effective way to power their vast and varied territories, particularly in regions like Egypt where sunlight was abundant. This interest from a global power marked a turning point, suggesting that Schuman's vision had the potential to transcend national boundaries and global influence on energy policies. It was a moment of validation for Schuman's work, hinting at a future where his sun-powered dream could become a widespread reality. Obstacles and decline. Just as Frank Schuman's sun engine began gaining international attention, a series of formidable obstacles emerged, casting a shadow over its future. The outbreak of World War I in 1914 marked a significant turning point. Global focus shifted toward the war effort, redirecting resources and attention away from innovative technologies like Schuman's solar engine. This shift was a critical blow to the momentum that the Sun engine had been gathering. Around the same time, another development further complicated the vision: the discovery and subsequent boom of cheap oil. This new, easily accessible energy source quickly became the preferred choice, overshadowing renewable energy solutions due to its cost-effectiveness and immediate availability. The allure of cheap oil was irresistible to an energy-hungry world, particularly in the context of post-war reconstruction and industrial expansion. Technically, Schuman's Sun engine faced its own set of challenges. While innovative, the technology was complex and expensive to implement on a large scale. Financial investment in such fantastic technology was a risky proposition for investors, especially compared to the rapidly expanding and profitable oil industry. These technical and financial hurdles, combined with the geopolitical upheaval of the time, led to the decline and eventual obscurity of the Sun engine. Schuman's work in solar energy to revolutionize the energy sector was relegated to the footnotes of history. Schuman's legacy and modern solar power. Although Frank Schuman's Sun engine faded into the background of history, his vision and predictions for solar energy were remarkably visionary. Long before the world recognizes the value of renewable energy, Schuman saw the sun as a powerful, untapped resource. He envisioned a future where solar power could meet the world's energy needs, reducing reliance on finite resources like coal and oil. Decades later, the 1973 oil crisis sparked a global realization that mirrored Schuman's foresight. As oil prices soared and concerns over energy security grew, the world began to seriously explore alternatives. This crisis reignited interest in solar energy, leading to significant investments and research in the field. Modern solar power, with its photovoltaic cells and large-scale solar farms, is a testament to the enduring relevance of Schuman's ideas. These contemporary developments in harnessing solar energy reflect the very principles he advocated: the use of the sun's abundant power as a clean, sustainable energy source. Schuman's legacy, therefore, is a foundation upon which the modern solar power movement is built. His early 20th century experiments laid the groundwork for today's solar technology, proving that his vision was not just a dream, but a viable pathway to a more sustainable future. In this way, Schuman's pioneering spirit lives on, inspiring ongoing efforts to harness the power of the sun. Frank Schuman's sun engine, a once-forgotten piece of history, now resonates more than ever in our quest for sustainable energy. His vision, far ahead of his time, challenges us to think, what other revolutionary ideas are we overlooking today that might shape our tomorrow?